recently I've been doing a lot of controversial videos, and I guess this is another one. I don't know, whatever. Some of you guys have been told that oils are bad for the hair and you should not use oils for your hair, which I think is crazy because of the simple fact that in our hair care regimen, oils are designed to either penetrate the hair or to protect the hair. And our hair is made up of oils. Yes, there's keratin. Yes, there's protein. However, there's cholesterol and there's ceramides and there's fatty acids and there's triglycerides. All of those are oils, okay? Now, of course, as a cosmetic chemist, you guys know I gotta go deeper, so bear with me here. So what exactly is an oil? An oil is made up of a glycerol and fatty acids. Typically, three fatty acids combined to a glycerol creates a triglyceride. Now, based off the fatty acid, that is going to determine what kind of oil it is, whether it's an avocado oil or apricot oil. When it comes to oils in our hair and the best oils for our hair, they're either going to be saturated fatty acids or monounsaturated fatty acids. Those two are the best oils for our hair if you're trying to have an oil that penetrates into the hair, because monounsaturated fatty acid and saturated fatty acids typically are linear. Monounsaturated, they do have a double bond that creates a bit of a branch, but it's not as branchy as the polyunsaturated, which I'll talk about in a few. Now, when it comes to saturated fatty acids and monounsaturated fatty acids, these oils typically are coconut oil, avocado, olive oil, babassu oil. Those are great oils for penetrating into the hair because chemically the way they look are very linear. Our hair, the cuticle, is also very linear. So these oils are actually able to have a better affinity to our hair because they're like this and it can actually penetrate into the hair like this, you know? Now, oils that penetrate into the hair are gonna be very beneficial against high growth fatigue. High growth fatigue is something that a lot of us experience, and half the time we don't even know that we are experiencing it. High growth fatigue is when our hair absorbs too much water. And when that happens, our hair expands, but then as it dries, it shrinks. And then we do it again, like wash our hair or have too much water on our hair, it expands and then it shrinks again. So this kind of stresses the hair out, which leads to frizziness and breakage and dryness and things that we do not want. And high growth fatigue is a result of missing pieces of our cuticle. So you're gonna want these oils to actually penetrate to the hair to fill in the gaps so that you can have a better lipid moisture balance, because either way, lipids do not moisturize the hair, water does, but you have to have the right balance to avoid high growth fatigue. And these penetrating oils that have high content of saturated and monounsaturated fatty acids are ideal for that. Now, on the flip side, you have polyunsaturated fatty acids. These oils typically have multiple double bonds and it really looks like a branched looking chemical composition. Now, even though these oils don't really penetrate to the hair, they do create a film around the hair that protects the hair. Now, for a long time, people thought that films on the hair are a bad thing. No, they're actually really good. So in the case of polyunsaturated fatty acids like hemp seed oil, sunflower, safflower, grapeseed oil, things like that, they're going to protect the hair, but they're also going to help to reduce the surface friction of the hair. What is surface friction? When your hair is dry and it's not coated with oils to help the hair glide across each other, you kind of have this dryness that goes on and your hair kind of just tangles up against each other and then rubs against each other, causing tangles and ultimately breakage. So you want a nice film on the hair, aka oils on the hair, that are going to help the hair to glide past each other without tangling up and causing breakage. So you're going to want oils that do have high polyunsaturated fatty acids in it, like the ones I just listed, because they are not going to penetrate, but they are going to stay on the outer part of the hair to help reduce that surface friction. Now, let's say you are on the other group that's like, you know, I don't like oils, they dry my hair out. The first thing I would say is, how much water are you consuming? Like, how much water are you drinking on a daily basis? Because that makes a huge difference when it comes to how oils operate with your hair. So that's number one. Number two, a lot of you guys say how you guys don't like coconut oil. A great one-to-one replacement is babassu oil that has a high level of saturated fatty acid, lauric acid, which is great for penetrating the hair. So I would definitely recommend babassu oil. And then lastly, as I mentioned before, look at the fatty acid composition of your your oils. Make sure they have a high amount of saturated or monounsaturated if you want it to penetrate, or a high amount of polyunsaturated if you just want it to coat the hair to once again reduce that surface friction. So it all depends on what you are trying to do. Not all oils are created the same. So if you guys enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed filming it for you guys, I have a question for you. If you had to go on an island for 3 months, right, but you only could pack one oil in your suitcase, just one oil, what would it be? Comment below. I can't wait to see your responses. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Definitely subscribe for more videos like this. Comment below, like this video. Check out the curlychemistry.com website for more awesome information like this and the Curly Girl's Guide to Haircare Ingredients, an amazing ebook that I just created just for you to learn more about ingredients in the natural hair care industry. All right, I love you guys. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.